Hello there guys, my name is Coaster Chall, onto the ball, but both theme park news, and welcome to a Coaster Chall vlog. Today we are here at the York Dungeon to experience their brand new seasonal show, War of the Roses, The Bloody Battle. Now this is a rendition in the Golden Fleece show that's going to be running for a couple of weeks to start off with. It's going to be running until February 29th, so make sure you go and check it out if you haven't already. So today I'm going to be going around the full York Dungeon experience. I'm going to be interviewing Ben, which is the marketing manager, like we did last year for the Curse of the Witch opening day. We're going to be asking them some questions about the show, any future projects, and then I'm going to be giving you my review of the whole experience and any changes that we spotted inside the dungeon in the other shows throughout the experience. So let's have our interview with Ben, and then we're going to go on my review afterwards. So we've just come out of the York Dungeon, and I'm here with Ben once again, the marketing manager of York Dungeon. Ben, it's lovely to see you again.
Yeah, lovely to see you as well.
Can't believe it's been a year since we were last here talking about the Curse of the Witch on the opening day. Can't believe it's been a year.
It's flown by, absolutely flown by. There's been that much going on. We've got so much going on this year as well.
Absolutely, and I can't wait to find out more. So just talking about the War of the Roses then, what sort of led to the decision to bring in the War of the Roses in the Golden Fleece scene?
Well, it's an iconic part of history, and you know, one of the primary focuses of the conflict was here in York. Because it's House of York and the House of Lancaster. And we decided that we wanted to look for a story outside of York. Because every story that we've got so far, they're all within the city. We wanted to branch out a little bit, and the story of the Battle of Towton really struck us as something that was significant, was incredibly important, was very gory and violent, which ticks all the boxes for us, but also is not necessarily as well known.
Yeah.
And that's one thing that we like to do, is we like to sometimes talk about some of the stories that aren't as well known, like Isabella Billington with Curse of the Witch.
Yes.
To bring the understanding and to bring that knowledge to a wider audience while giving them a great time and entertaining them.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So how did you sort of piece it all together? How did you sort of bring it all together? Was it just a simple just telling of the actors and changing of the script, or was it a bit more than that?
Well, the performance team and the displays team do a lot of research into the time that these stories are set and who the people were at that time. So they really, really put in that work to make everything as authentic as possible.
Yeah.
Once you get the authentic stuff, then you can add the dungeon stuff onto it.
Yeah.
I think if we did it the other way around, it wouldn't be as legitimate.
Yeah.
You know, you don't want people to walk out thinking that was fine, but I don't believe it. Whereas if they walk out saying, oh, that was something that happened, but we saw it in a slightly different, scary, fun way.
Yeah.
Once we've done that, then all the research is done, then the script is written. The script is then, you know, passed around a few people just to make sure that it hits all the dungeon tick boxes. And then once it's signed off, we then send it out to the actors. And then we start the rehearsal process. And it's quite an intense rehearsal process. But we get everybody signed off very, very quickly on it. And just the way that the performance team, they're so good at what they do, you know, they'll take these actors, they'll give them the script, and then they come in and they know it all. It's just a case of, right, can we find where the buttons are? Can we make sure that we've got it all set? But everybody who does it for the public has been signed off quite recently. And I mean, I don't know what you think, but when I see that show, I think it looks like they've been doing it for years because they know it so well.
Absolutely, it's really brilliant. Am I right in saying this is a seasonal thing? This is not a permanent show?
Yeah, as it stands, and I always say as it stands because with dungeons, you never know. Sometimes we just like throw in a little bit of a surprise. As it stands, we're running it for 2 weeks.
Okay.
It'll be from today, February 15th, all the way through February 29th.
Thank you.
And then we'll see what's happening going forward, but this is the first of three shows that we're going to be doing this year.
Fantastic. So is there anything you can tell us about anything else that's coming for the 2020 season?
Absolutely. So in May we're going to be doing another show launch, and that's going to be our big permanent show launch, and it will revolve around Guy Fawkes. I'm not going to say any more on it at all, but it will be to do with Guy Fawkes. And then around Halloween, we're going to be taking a slightly different track with Halloween this year.
Okay.
Last year, we were the home of Halloween. This year, we are still going to be the place to come for Halloween and the home of Halloween, but we're going to be focusing a little bit more on some of the spirits of York.
Okay, so
we are going to be having, well, at the moment, I'd say we have Curse of the Witch as our terrifying show.
Yeah.
all the others are scary, Fungus, which is terrifying, and Halloween will have two terrifying shows in the dungeon.
Yeah. Very interesting. So with the, obviously you can't say more about the Guy Fawkes show from in May, but am I right in saying this replacing the Talking Heads, or is this going to be an extension?
You might think that, I couldn't possibly comment.
Oh! So I know I said it earlier, I need to watch out for a show that might look like it might be going. I don't know if the Talking Heads looked like it was going, I thought it was all running well.
It is, but with what we like to do is we always like to keep things fresh, and we always like to look and see how can we adapt and how can we change.
Yeah.
Okay. Thing. So there will be a show that will be changing.
Okay.
And it will be coming, this new show that may or may not focus on Guy Fawkes. And then at Halloween we will be introducing a limited run show that is set to be one of the scariest in dungeon history across the board. And I won't say what it is, but I will say to people, bring your Ouija boards with you. It's going to get pretty freaky.
Oh, very interesting there. So, finally, we asked this question last year. I mean, what would you say to people out there? Why should they come to your dungeon? Why is it such a fantastic experience?
Because if you don't, then you're being soft. No, it's because it offers something for everybody. We're cheeky, we're rascals, we're very in your face. Everybody is welcome to the dungeon. We are a family attraction. I think that's something that people forget sometimes. So it's scary, but it's also funny. Nothing that we do is going to be unsuitable for anybody, say, aged 8 and up. And, you know, we've also got things like our Dungeon Lakes, we've got our Hen and Stag Days, if you're wanting a slightly naughtier experience as well. And there's just a variety of shows, and where else are you going to find this much entertainment within 75 minutes?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So, Ben, thank you very much again for
coming along.
Make sure you check out for the War of the Roses, the Bloody Battle show, running up until February 29th. And please come down and check it out. And now it's time for my review. So I've just come out of the York dungeon, the most terrifying dungeon of them all. And I've just done the War of the Roses show, as well as the other shows incorporated in the dungeon. So this is going to be the massive review today. This is just talking about the whole changes with the War of the Roses, like we spoke about with Ben earlier. Again, I'll release that interview in a separate video as well. But today's also about talking about the changes in some of the other shows that I spotted throughout the experience. So let's start off with the other changes that we spotted throughout the rest of the experience before we go on about War of the Roses. So, two main changes that I spotted was in the second show, The Vengeance of the Vikings, and that is the Grid Viper Pit. If you guys have been in the dungeon, you know that below on the map there's like a grid with like Viper projections. That grid has been removed. I spoke to Ben about it, as you just saw in the interview. You know, he felt like it was a bit naff, so what they've done is replaced the grid. So they've got like a nice carpet, but they've increased the drop. For those of you who don't know, basically you're on like a grid and it sort of shakes about a bit and drops about a bit. They've removed the grid and the Viper projections and just increased the drop, which I think personally is a better experience. The Viper grid looks great, but I feel like the increase in drop and the nice carpet instead is a great fit for this show. Another big change that I spotted is in the Mirror Maze section of Margaret Cliffrun. That show is fantastic as it is. But what I saw through the Mirror Maze section of Margaret Cliffrun is they've added a couple more theming items. The third and final big change that I spotted was during the Executioner scene, actually, before we went into the Witch. And the Executioner scene, there was like a staircase behind me, and there was like a massive arch story. I don't know whether it's always been there, but it feels like that's always been covered before today. I saw the staircase going up to like an arch door, so I'm wondering if they're going to expand that way and then route that if they're going to do a show behind that arch door down to the Executioner and have a new exit to that show, and then have a new show behind that door and then route it back through, because I did see a pathway as we were walking down towards the Witch show. I did see a pathway coming in literally from that side, so I wonder if they're going to use that staircase as a brand new exit to the Executioner in the future and have a brand new show up there and then route it back round to the Witch. Again, we don't know these things at the minute, so we'll have to keep our eyes out for that, but I thought it was a very interesting spot. Those are the three big changes. Now, the War of the Roses. Now, we spoke about it in the interview, as you saw earlier in the video with Ben, and basically what we saw was basically the whole War of the Roses thing, if you didn't know, is basically some script changes, some change in a couple of scenery. It was still like the Golden Fleece Inn, but what they did was they put a picture of Edward IV in the background instead of the criminal that was like the hangman that was before when the York Ghost came in with the Golden Fleece in. Like I said, it's a seasonal show, so they'll probably change the picture back to the Hangman Criminal, and they'll get the original script back if they're not going to run it further on. But they still kept the same... They had script changes, but they still kept the same See Thee in Hell, which they used as part of the original show. I thought the script changes were fantastic. I feel like when I sort of had a feeling it would be the same like Golden Fleece show, but they had the War of the Roses changes, I thought, I hope they change the script well, and I hope they implement the story into the original script. They did it fantastically. I think they did it brilliantly. The jet at the end through the curtains, again, got me every time. And overall, I think for a seasonal show for a couple of weeks, I think it's a good change. And it's a good way to celebrate a piece of York history. So, like you said in the interview, there's a brand new show coming in May. Obviously, you guys know that 21st to the 25th of May, I'm in Prague. I'll be bringing the camcorder with me to get some brilliant footage, get my two swords, Prague Zoo, and anything else I can get as well. So you guys know I'm in Prague for a few days at the end of May. So if the show, I'm guessing the show will probably open before that. So obviously, you guys know if you guys are down in York in May when we get the official opening date for this brand new show, as you saw in the interview, rumoured to be about Guy Fawkes. We don't know for certain yet. So yeah, if you're down there in York and you see me, come for a photo. I'll be all for it. And also, don't forget, guys, May's also a big month for Portland's Park, which is known as Springs. Still don't know if I'm coming down there for that or not. That's exclusively on the 15th of May for VIPs. I've been invited to that. Again, don't know if I'm going yet or not, but I'll let you guys know in the future. So we've got some big stuff planned for May, and this just adds to the busy May schedule. So I'm really excited for that. He also spoke in the interview about another October show for Halloween. So again, very excited for that. So yeah. Thank you guys so much for watching this review of York Dungeon here in February. I'm going to do a full trip review, so not just this whole experience, but the merchandise, the shop, the pre-show, the whole atmosphere of getting out of the day. I'm going to be bringing all of that to you guys as well in the trip review when I'm back at my studio. So I hope you guys are excited for that video coming up. We've got plenty of theme park news updates coming up from a park in Japan for a 2021 coaster. We've got reviews, we've got loads of stuff coming on the channel. Obviously, you know about the badge change, so I cannot wait to show you guys more with the name, well, not really name change, but like the sort of badge change that's coming up next year, hopefully. So fingers crossed that all goes through. And for now, guys, thank you very much for watching my review. See you guys for more content very, very soon. Please like, comment, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. Please share with your friends, family, and on social media. And also make sure you get your questions in the comments down below for the Q&A session to celebrate our 1,500 subscriber milestone. A couple of weeks after we hit that milestone, we'll release the Q&A. All your questions have been marked. Use the hashtag question before or after your question in the comments section below. We'll be starting on Instagram very soon as well. Thank you very much. My name is Coaster Chall, YouTube channel. Keep living the coaster life. And I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day.